Hi all, welcome to today's video lecture. In this today's lecture, I am going to cover three main important string functions. The first one is string length, and then concatenation of strings, and then comparison of strings by using C, Java, as well as Python languages. So coming to string operations in C language. So first I am going to find out the length of the given string. To find out the length of the given string, we have strlen function in C language, actually which is defined in string.h header file. And then if you observe the syntax here, the function name is strlen, which is taking string as an argument and returning the length of type size underscore t. Size underscore t, unsigned integer type, we are going to use to hold the number of bytes returned by most of the operations in C language. How you can use this strlen function to get the length of a string, I will show now. Now I am declaring a string variable. My string variable name is name, and which can hold 100 characters. Then I am initializing my string variable with a string. Welcome is the string I have in that string variable name. And then I am declaring another variable of type size underscore t. Name of the variable is n. Now I am using strlen function defined in string.h header file. Before using that, I have to include that header file. I have included the string.h header file. Then I am using strlen function to get the length of this string. See, I have used this function with input argument name string, and then the returned length will be loaded into n. Then I am displaying the length of the string. To display a number of type size underscore t, the format specifier is %ZU. Now I am running the program. See, the input string is welcome, which is having total 7 characters in it. That's why the length is 7 now. Instead of using size underscore t as data type for return value, we can also use integer here without having any problem. If you use integer as data type to hold the return value, then the format specifier should be %d. Then if I run the program, the same result I got. I am changing the input string. Now my input string is welcome underscore all. Then if I run this program, I will get 11 as the number of characters in that string. See, welcome all, including the space, total we have 11 characters in it. So after string length, the next function I'm going to consider is string concatenation. By using string concatenation, we can concatenate two strings. So which is also defined in string.h header file. And then if you observe the syntax of this string concatenation function, the name of the function is strcat, and which is taking two arguments, string 1 and string 2. If you use this function, automatically string 2 will be appended at the end of the string 1, and this function returns that appended string as the output. Switching to the compiler. So we are going to generate a full name by considering the first name and the last name of a person. For that string concatenation function I am using. So before using that string concatenation function, I need to include the respective header file, that is string.h, in the program. Now I am going to declare three string variables. Fname is a variable I have to hold the first name of a person. Then I have initialized it with Rama. Lname is a variable I am using to hold the string last name, that is initialized with Krishna. And then I am using a variable full name for the holding a string after concatenation of first name and the last name. Here the full name is initialized with empty string. Then I am using three concatenation functions to append first name, last name with a space separation. After this first string concatenation function, full name will have Rama in it. So after this second string concatenation function, full name will have Rama and then a space in it. After this third string concatenation function, full name will have Rama space Krishna in it. Now I am going to display this entire full name by using a printf statement. If I run the program, then I will get the full name Rama space Krishna. Next, we are going to see the comparison of two strings. So in order to compare two strings, we have strcmp function in the same string.h header file. See, that is defined in the string.h header file. And if you observe the syntax here, the strcmp function will take two arguments, string1 and string2. Both the strings will be compared because of this string comparison function and returns an integer. Then if string1 and string2 both are same, then automatically this function returns 0. If string1 is greater than string2, automatically it will return a positive number, which indicates the difference between these two strings. And if string1 is less than string2, which returns a negative value. To explain the operation of string comparison function, I am going to consider a simple thing here, that is password checking. So we are going to ask the user to enter the password, and then we are going to check that entered password is correct or not for the logging. Since we are using string comparison function here, we need to include string.h header file. Then we need a string variable to hold the string entered by the user. See, here I am using a string variable pwd, which is nothing but a character array, and it can hold 21 characters in it. That means the end user can enter the password up to 20 characters. Then automatically the 21st character will be a null character. Then I am prompting the user to enter the password. Then I am reading that password by using scanf statement. Since we are using scanf statement to read that password, it does not accept any spaces or tabs in the password. So after reading the password, we are comparing that password with the fixed password. Here I have fixed my password as 12345, and then the password entered by the user is their pwd variable. Then both are compared because of the string comparison function. If both are matched, automatically it will return 0. Then I am displaying a statement, password matched. Else, if password entered by the user is not matched with 12345, then I am going to display a statement, password mismatch, in the next line. So that's it. I am going to run the program. It is prompting to enter a password. Then I am entering 12345, a correct password. Then password matched, the statement is displayed like this. So let me enter a wrong password by running the program again. I am entering some wrong password. Then password wrong statement I got. Now we will look at some basic string operations in Java. For that, I am considering a string object of a class string. Now I am going to explain the first function to find out the length of this string. See, in order to find the length of this string, the string object is having length method. By using that length method, we can find out the number of characters with that string object. So this length method returns an integer. So we can store that returned integer into an integer variable. To show how to find out the length of the string, so I am going to consider a string object. Then I have considered a string India, and then the string reference variable is str, which is of class string. Then I am going to find out the length of the string by using length method with that string object. See, here I am using an integer n to hold that returned integer value, which is nothing but the length of this string object. Here length does not take any input parameters. And then I am displaying the length. If I run the program, I got the length as 5. Then I am changing the input string. Now my string is India is my country. I am going to run this program. Then I got total 19. Total 19 characters that entire string literal is having, including spaces. Next, we will see how to concatenate strings. In order to concatenate strings in Java, we have two options. The first option is using concatenation operator, and the second option is by using concatenate method associated with that string object. Here in the first method, the operator we are using is plus. So if you use plus symbol between the strings, automatically that will act as concatenation operator. See, by using this plus symbol here, we can actually concatenate multiple strings. In this example, if you observe, I have concatenated multiple strings by using plus symbol, and then I have loaded that concatenated string into a new string object. And the next one is using concat method. Here the usage of the concat method is string1.concat string2. Then concat method is taking another string as input, and then it will concatenate that string 2 at the end of the string 1 and it returns a new string. Let me consider the first name and the last name of the person and to generate a full name by using those two names. Here fname is the first name, that is Google, and lname is the last name, that is drive. Then I am using another string variable, full name, which is the result of concatenation of first name, last name with space separation. Here for the concatenation, I have used plus operator. So now I am displaying full name. If I run the program, I got the Google Drive with space separation. So instead of using plus operator, we can also use concat method associated with string object. Let me use that. Here I have cascaded the concatenation methods. See, so first name is concatenated with a space, and then that entire result is concatenated with last name. If I run this program now, I will get the same Google Drive with space separation. Then I have changed the last name into folder. I am going to run it. Then I got the result Google space folder. So after string concatenation, the next operation I am considering is string comparison. Here we are going to compare two strings. For that, Java is having support for three different methods. The first one is method equals, and the second one is equals ignore case, and the third one is compare to. If you use equals method, automatically it will compare the string 1 and the string 2. Then if both are same, it returns a boolean value true. Otherwise, it will return a false as a boolean value. And then we have equals ignore case method. So string 1 and string 2 will be compared without considering any case of the letters, and then it also returns a boolean value. So ignoring case, if both strings are same, then it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. And the third one we have is compare to method, which will compare the string 1 and string 2. The usage is like this: string 1 dot compare to and string 2. Then string 1 is compared with another string, string 2. It will return integer value. See, if the string 1 and string 2 both are same, then it returns 0. And if string 1 is less than string 2, it will return a negative value as integer. If string 1 is greater than string 2, it will return a positive value as integer. Then we are going to write a program to check the password. First of all, we have to prompt the end user to enter the password. For that, I need to use a scanner object. For that, I am importing the scanner class. So after importing the scanner class, we have to create an object for it. Now our scanner object is SC. And then I am using a print statement to prompt the user. Then I am reading the password from the user by using next line method in scanner object. Now the string variable pwd is having the password. Now we need to check that entered password is matched with our existing password. Now this equals method returns true if the string available in pwd variable matches with 12345. Then I am displaying password correct statement. Else I am displaying password is wrong. Now I am running the program. If I run the program, now it is asking the password. Now I am entering the correct password, that is 12345. If I press enter, then I got a message, password is matched. Then I am running again. Now I am entering the wrong password, 12457. Then it is showing password is wrong. So here I have used equals method. Instead of using equals method, we can also use compare to method. Equals method returns boolean value, but compare to method returns integer value. If pwd is matched with 12345, it will return 0. Then we need to compare that return value with 0. Then I am running the program. If I run the program, It is prompting me to enter the password. Now I am entering the correct password. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I got the message password matched. Then if I run again, then wrong password I am entering. Then password wrong message it is displayed. Now basic string operations in Python. First we will see string length. In order to find the string length in Python, we have inbuilt function len. The usage of the len function is len input argument is an object. Then automatically this len function returns the number of elements present in this object. If this object is a string, each string element is nothing but a character string, then automatically this len function with string input returns the number of characters in that string which we are going to load into a variable. Then string length in Python. Then I am considering a string variable name, and then I am initializing that with a string. Now my string is Python 3. Since Python is dynamically typed language, no need to declare that variable before using it. So runtime the type will be decided. Then I am using another variable to hold the length. Then the variable n holds the number of characters available in that string. Then I am displaying that length. Then I am running the program. Then I got 7. Total 7 characters we have in that string Python 3. So in order to concatenate strings in Python, we have 2 methods. The first one is by using concatenation operator, and the second one is by using join method. If you consider the first method, plus is the concatenation operator in Python to concatenate multiple strings. See, this is the usage of the concatenation operator. See here, I have concatenated multiple strings, string 1, string 2, and so on, and then I am loading the combined string into a new string. And then coming to the next one, join method. By using join method, we can combine multiple strings using delimiter. See, I have given the usage here. So delimiter dot join and then list of strings. Then I am supplying this list of strings as input for this join method. Then all these strings will be combined with a delimiter separation. Switching to Jupyter notebook. Then in order to explain the concatenation operator, I am considering 2 string variables. So the first string variable is str1, which is holding Indian as a string, and the second string variable is str2, which is holding army as a string. Then to concatenate these 2 strings, I am using concatenation operator plus. See, I have concatenated 2 strings str1 and str2 with a space separation, and then I am loading the resultant string into string 3. Then I am displaying the concatenated string. See, I got Indian space army. And the next way of concatenating strings is join method. Then I am joining both the strings str1 and str2 with a space separation. Then the delimiter here is space. Since join requires a list as input, I have mentioned str1 and str2 as a list into that join method with a delimiter space. Again, I am running the program. Then I got the same result, Indian Army. My string 2 is having goods now. Now I am combining these 2 strings using a delimiter hash. If I run the program, between Indian and goods, we will get hash. And then string comparison. In Python, there is no separate method available for the comparison of strings. We can make use of comparison operators to compare strings. These are the various comparison operators we have in Python. Equal, less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal. See, the usage is string 1 comparison operator, string 2. These parentheses are optional. Then if you use like this, based on the comparison, you will get either true or false. That means this comparison returns a boolean value. If the comparison is satisfied, the variable will have true. If the comparison is failed, then the variable will get false. To explain about the comparison operation, I am considering password checking. Then I am prompting the user to enter the password. To get the input from the user, I have used input statement. Then PWD is a variable which holds the password entered by the user. Now we need to compare that entered password with actual password. Now I am using if condition in which I am checking the string in the PWD variable with ABCD. I am assuming ABCD is the actual password. If both are matched, this if condition will be satisfied. then I am displaying password is matched. Else I am displaying password mismatch. I am running the program. It is asking for a password. Then I am entering the correct password. Then I got a message, password matched. Again I am running the program. Then I am entering some wrong password, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 I have entered. Then password wrong statement is displayed. So that's all with string functions.